Okay.
All right. So don't, feel free to ask questions, because people that take the class after, they love it when people ask questions because they usually think of them. So we're going to use one of our sponges, and we're going to use the black paint first and paint all of our backing black. And just go back and forth, side to side. You can put it on your plate if you want, or you can use it right out of your cup, whichever is easier for you.
I totally should have put paper down. I didn't think about that.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I give it to you in paper or in a bag?
In a bag.
Oh, okay. Well, I ran out of the brown paper, so I the last couple I've been doing in a bag. You can cut the bag in half.
Yeah, open it up. Okay.
I usually give out brown paper so that you can use it like a tablecloth.
Right.
But I just ran out. Which is a good thing I ran out, and I don't have 100 pounds of it, but I got to get more. Yeah, that Willie Nelson one is super cute, isn't it?
My favorite ever.
Yeah, that I ordered for Honor Flight last year. So Honor Flight did a fundraiser with me last year, and because people weren't getting the concept of how to do the pre-order thing, you know, like you had to order it by a certain day, I ordered a few extras of this, a few extras of that, and that just happened to be one of my extras.
I loved it.
Yeah, I sold almost all of the extras so far. I think I have two Americas left, and that's it. I even posted them with Trump and Biden on them, and nobody bought them yet.
What were they, just regular flags?
They were circles like this, but they had the sunglasses in the middle, and they said America. And then one I put like the, I cut out a stencil on my Cricut, and I made the word Trump on it. And put, I showed it on the computer, like I did a digital thing, and I put the Trump and I put the Biden so they could add it if they wanted to.
Oh, okay. Nobody, and no one bought?
Yeah. They're too busy running down the road with their big flag sticking out of the truck. Just joking. Today at Publix, I saw another guy with like 14 flags sticking out of the back of his truck.
You would think that'd be really bad on your gas.
You'd think that'd be really bad on your truck.
Yeah.
My husband has a truck, and he's like, I'll never attach anything like that to my truck.
Right.
Like, what if it breaks? What if it snaps off? What if it hit, goes pole vaulting into the sky and kills somebody? I can't even handle that. Right. Yeah. Yeah, but some people don't think. I had a guy get mad at me today. Give me the finger. Because I was going 15 miles over the speed limit on North Lake, but that wasn't quite fast enough for him.
Oh my gosh, I don't even get me started on that road.
I hate that road with a passion.
Now that it's 45, it gives me anxiety to drive that, because I don't want to break the speed limit.
Yeah.
And, you know, people like come up on your butt going like 70 miles an hour. It's terrifying.
I was going 70 because I was going with the flow, but that wasn't quick enough for him. So he
sped
around me and he gave me the finger. I'm like, whatever, dude. Have a good life. And I didn't feel like I was going super fast, you know. This was in the middle, though, closer to grassy waters. Doesn't the speed limit change there?
No, it's 50.
50? Yeah.
Or 55, something like that.
Yeah, so I was going at least 15 over. I guess I shouldn't be recording that part, but I don't care. All right, so once you get all the black done, you can just set
I'm not
it
even
aside. That's fine.
It's taking forever. I don't know why.
Take your time. It soaks in too, so you might want to give it a minute anyways.
It's just not, I have a little, I don't have a big sponge.
I'm so bad. I didn't give you a big one?
Nope, it's all little ones.
Sorry.
I have a big one somewhere. I just don't know exactly where it is.
That's all right. Take your time. It's a good arm workout.
Yeah.
Going back and forth. I love this one, though. Last year, we did the Hocus Pocus truck, and that one was really hard for everybody, but I did a lot of them.
This one's what, like a ceramic?
No, it was a wood shape. And it was a truck like this one. Let me see. I don't know where my Hocus Pocus truck is. Even if I have one left, I might have sold it. It was a truck shaped like this. See how big it is?
Oh, yeah.
But it had the people in the back.
Oh, that's cute.
It had the girls in the back. And it was pretty hard because it was like 3D. It was three layers. Like this was three layers, but then I have a Santa one, Mr. and Mrs. Claus too, one like that.
Cute.
I can still get the Hocus Pocus truck. I just didn't offer it as a class this year because I did it last year and I have a lot of the same customers, but I have it on the Facebook page somewhere. You can order it.
Yeah, I love Hocus Pocus.
I think, and then I have the cauldron with them in it, and they're coming out of the top, and the bubbles. That one was really cute, too. I did that one last year. And I might have one of those left. I'll look and see the cauldron. I'm not sure.
Okay.
I can tell you. I'll make notes. I always forget things. I say I'm going to do all this stuff and I forget, so I've been making notes. This is my notes. Look at.
Oh my gosh.
My phone goes crazy. It's just, then the highlights mean that I did it. So if it's not highlighted, I have to check and see if I did it.
Oh my gosh.
I know. Oh. Did you check the bathroom light? The bathroom light is connected to that.
What happened? Oh boy, you hit it.
Uh-oh.
Oh boy, what happened? Good grief.
Is he all right?
Yes, he was, I heard a smack in the, at the tile and he was spinning around and spun too fast and fell down.
My goodness. Was he dancing?
He was spinning in a circle. Oh man, I think you're going to have a black eye. He didn't even catch himself. He just smacked his face right into the tile.
Poor thing.
You're crazy. Well, lay down with your little crack blanket, okay? I know food's coming, okay? Yeah.
And it's not like we can have a lot of carpet because in here in Florida, it gets all gross.
Oh, yeah, it does. This house, in the living room, there's carpet and it's gross.
Yeah.
Okay. Finally covered.
No worries. So just set it aside, let it dry. Again, as it dries, we might see a few spots that we have to like touch up on.
Okay.
Now you're going to need, so see this part right here where it's burnt? This is the back side. Okay. So we're going to flip it over and use this side. So we're going to do the orange piece here so we can let this dry. You can change the colors up if you want to. You don't have to do all the same colors I'm doing. You can change it up and make it different colors if you want. But in the picture, this one's orange. And if the orange is too dark, you can always add a little white to it and make it lighter. But it should be okay. We'll probably have to do two coats though. We might, let me try it and see if it's gonna. No, it should be all right. We'll do two coats, so it'll be brighter. Okay. Sorry, I'm eating. One of my wholesalers sent me a bag of caramel popcorn.
Ooh.
I'm like chowing on that because it's, you know, fair time for them and stuff. So they start making that stuff for their shows, their big shows.
It's like fresh kettle
mm-hmm. It's like a big long sleeve of kettled caramel corn. This particular wholesaler's in Texas, and they have a big show in October or September, Canton, Texas, I think. So they start making it and they start offering it to, if you buy so much dollars worth of stuff, they send you a free bag. And okay. I hit that mark almost every time. I would say it's the kettle corn that motivates me, but I've been trying to walk every day, so.
Listen, it is hot enough that you're probably getting a good workout in.
I am, and I'm trying to walk in the morning, like early, but. I didn't walk today because I had a customer coming over. She lives in half her time here and half her time up north. And she's only here for a month. And she's got like standing appointments with me for once a week, you know, she comes in at 2:10 and leaves like at 2:03, whatever. And she spends all day painting because she buys hundreds of dollars worth of stuff, and then I save it all up. She comes down, she picks it up, she paints some here, she takes some with her.
Oh, wow.
She makes a lot for gifts, and she does a lot for charity, so. But she enjoys painting, and she's retired. She loves it.
That's the kind of life I would want, just doing crafts every day. Mom.
Yeah, so she sits here and chit-chats with me, and I do my work around her, and she sits in my studio seat, I call it, because this is where I do all the filming. And she likes this chair, so she sits here.
That's awesome.
Uh-huh. But I had to leave her. I had to get her to go by 3:30 today because I had to go do deliveries for tomorrow's class.
Oh, yeah. I haven't done a virtual class yet.
Well, this is considered a virtual class, so you're doing one.
Yep.
Your very first one.
I think it's kind of awesome and opened you up to more.
Yeah, it is, but a lot of people are afraid of it. They don't know that they can do it without me seeing them, or, you know, like, go incognito and do it. They don't know all those things. So they think, oh my God, I got to get on camera. I'm like, no, you don't.
I've never used a visual camera, and I'm like, nope.
No, you don't have to. As long as you can see me, that's all that matters.
Oh yeah, this is gonna need another coat.
Yeah, it'll need another coat, but we'll let it dry for a minute. So while that's drying, we'll paint our girls.
They're purple.
Yeah, they're purple, but I think we're going to have to mix a little white into the purple because the purple is very opaque. So I'm going to try this real quick and see how much we need. So you have a cup full of purple and white, right?
Yes, I have a bunch.
I'm just going to, so I have like 2 big scoops of purple and 1 scoop of white, and I'm going to mix it together here because I think that the first coat will not be showing up pretty much. So we're gonna do, take your bigger, one of these brushes and take 2 scoops of the purple out and 1 scoop of white out and mix those 2 colors together.
You gave me bottles.
Oh, I gave you bottles, that's right. I gave you bottles because you had quite a bit of stuff. So squirt out like 2 quarter sizes of purple and then 1 quarter size of white. Like this. This size, like a quarter size.
Okay.
And then we'll brush this with the light purple first, and then we'll use just the plain purple on top. Because I don't think that the purple will, I think it'll be too opaque. Yeah, because this is kind of lavender, but when we put the second coat of purple on, we'll just use regular purple. I usually do little cups for people. That's why I keep saying cups.
Yes, my Willy one came with that. Yeah. But yeah, since I ordered like half of your store.
Well, I just didn't want it to dry out, not knowing with the new baby how much time you had on each project, you know?
Right.
Yeah, I was just trying to be mindful of that.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
You're welcome. I don't have little babies, but I have grandkids. So I had a baby at one time. I know how hard it is.
It is. And I didn't think it was going to be hard with 2, but ooh.
Yes.
Yeah. Especially because my 5-year-old is going through something currently, and it's trying.
It might be the new baby.
Yeah, that's what we've been told. It seems like it might be.
Yeah, because 5 years alone is a long time.
Right. That's why I keep telling myself I just gotta, and you know, and then everything with school stopping and all of that was a lot.
Oh, yeah.
You know, he was super excited to start kindergarten, and now that that's not happening, he's pretty upset about it.
Yeah. I know Planet Kids started back up.
Yeah, I think that, but they're all daycares. He's starting kindergarten.
Oh, I thought they had a pre-K program there. I could be wrong. I don't know. Like I said, I don't have a kid in school, so I've done some work with them before, but it's been all like it's been more summer campy things, you know.
Mhm. Yeah, he was supposed to start up here's Hammock.
Oh, yeah. Well, hopefully in the next couple months, they just had the big meeting, so.
Yeah. I just want him to go to school normal. If he has to wear, like, a mask or something, that's not going to work.
Yeah, he's too young.
Come on, them five-year-olds are going to see someone else that has a cooler mask than theirs, and they're going to want to trade.
Exactly. I was just going to say that. It's going to be like that thing on Facebook where the lady comes, picks her kid up, and she's like, oh, that's not the mask I sent you to school with. She's like, and the kid goes, no, this is the one that I traded with so-and-so, and so-and-so traded with a so-and-so. So now it's down to three people. So.
Exactly. And my son would definitely partake in that. So unless it's like normal, he's not going to go to school. I can't even get him to wear them when we go into a store.
Yeah, must be hard.
You know?
Yeah, five, and my grandson, who's seven, can't even understand it, so.
They can't see it, you know? So they're like.
Like they don't believe you because they can't physically see something.
Right.
So we'll let that dry for a minute. Take your time, go to your pace. I'm here for you. I paint these every day, so I'm used to them.
Yeah, I'm done. I'm ready.
Okay. So set this aside and then grab your letters. And this is where our makeup sponge comes in handy. Those little makeup sponges. Mm-hmm. I gave you those, right? The little white triangles?
Yes.
Yeah. I always forget something on someone, so I always say that. I always say, did I give that to you? Did I give that to you? And I'm being serious. I honestly always forget something.
Well, it's a lot.
It is a lot, especially when you're, you know, like you're putting it all together for kids. You're like, okay. Do they need this? Do they need that? Like when it's in the studio, if you need it and I didn't give it to you, then it's right there. I can just give it to you. So, all right. Mm-hmm. So take just a little bit of white and then probably a quarter size and then like a couple of things of yellow and then mix those two colors together. Either with the back of one of the handles or a little paintbrush if you have it. Just get it all blended together because we want it to be bright. So the white helps because the yellow is another opaque color. And then we'll do a second coat with just the yellow on top. But the good thing about all these colors we're mixing up, they're good for our dots that we're going to put in the black thing. So we're not wasting them. They won't go to waste, I should say. Move my orange aside. I only have so much camera room. So what we're gonna do is take one of our makeup sponges and I hold it by the skinny side and I use the fat side and I just dip it in the paint like this, take some off so it's not soaked and I just kind of pounce it on like this and I rub it on. So I do a little bit of both. So I pounce some on and then I kind of just rub it around. And if it goes over the edges, I just take the baby wipe and wipe it up. That's why I pounce on first because it gives it coverage. And then I go back and rub it. You don't want it to like spill over like that. See how it's starting to spill over? Because it keeps your lines nice and your black nice and black. Oh, that's why I say baby wipes are the best thing because they work so quick for you. And they're cheap. Well, not that cheap. But they're cheaper than paper towels, I think.
Oh, yeah. They work better.
Yeah. They're already wet. You don't want to wet them. So we're going to do two coats. So we'll just do one coat. If you need to, I pounce it and I leave it flat so it doesn't break. Because if you pick the letters up, they break sometimes. And you'll see it layer up the paint as we do two coats. The first one, you'll still see a little wood through. It's okay. Sometimes I just take the, because these are laser burned, you always get a little bit of that black on there too. If you find you don't have enough glue for all the projects I gave you, just let me know and I'll drop some by.
Okay.
I think I gave you like 6 or 8 tubes. I can't remember, but.
Yeah, it looked like a lot.
But if you find it's not enough, just let me know.
I don't have glue.
Is he hungry? Is he hungry? Bring me my pillow.
Baby's waking up.
Yes, and Emily, what time is it? 7:30? Man, it's been like 45 minutes. What's he thinking? Oh, yeah, yeah, it's been like constant. Well, now that I know the camera's a lot, let me take this.
Right. I can't see anything, so you're good.
Safe.
Yeah, this is like an arm workout in itself here.
Yeah,
oh, am I doing this one the right way? This one I think is upside down. So the reason you can tell if they're upside down is if you see the burn marks on them. Mm-hmm. Right here, I can see a little bit of the burn mark. So I think it goes this way, which makes more sense because I don't see any of the burn. I just see black soot. But on the O's, I don't think it would make a difference anyways.
Okay.
Either way, but if it doesn't look right, just turn it around. Maybe that's why. That's what I always tell people. If it doesn't look like it's going the right way.
I wasn't sure about the S's, but I think they're supposed to be the bigger one on top.
Yeah. Daddy? Yeah, because this one, this C goes down here. Yeah, so the Hocus is bigger than the Pocus. Yeah, we'll see it when we lay it out. We won't glue it until we know. My letters just kind of fell down on the table, so they're all mixed up. Are they sending any kind of virtual work home for the kindergartners or no?
I went through him and we're doing the Florida virtual.
Oh, okay.
So start date, because I didn't want to deal with the back and forth, like not knowing when they would open. And then when they did, if someone was positive and they're closing again, like I didn't want to deal with all the, because there's so much uncertainty.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, we're just going to homeschool them and figure it out.
Yeah. And if,
you know.
The good thing is that he's still so young that even if you homeschooled him for a year or 2 years, he'll still get the socialization skills in when it's really vital, you know?
Even right. And he's been a day person too. And so he was still in, he was at VPK until they closed it for COVID, you know, in March.
Mm-hmm.
He has, you know, he's had that experience.
Right.
You know, I'm not too worried about that. And then, there's food here. And my mom works with him every Monday and Tuesday and does like schoolwork and stuff. So it's not anything he's not used to, you know?
Right. So he's getting different people too. So that's good.
Right.
Because sometimes parents get frustrated when it's just them.
Oh yeah.
I wouldn't be able to homeschool. Never. I can barely take this class.
I'm a little scared, to be honest.
No, I just don't think I'd have the patience for it 8 hours a day or 6 hours a day, you know?
Right, and the good thing about doing like the way we're doing it is he doesn't have to sit in front of the computer from 8 a.m. until 2 p.m.
Right.
You know, if he was part of school, he would have to do that, and there's no way he'd be able to.
Right.
So when we do our own thing, then.
I have a bunch of friends that do homeschooling and do Florida Virtual, and they do it at their own pace, and their kids are fine.
Great. And he's only maturity-wise, he's not at all. Maturity-wise, he is not ready for school, like a school setting.
Right.
But intellectually, he's ahead. So it's I'm okay with him still staying home some, you know?
Yeah. Well, my daughter-in-law, my son held my grandson back a year because of his maturity level. So they said it's the best thing for him.
I think so too, yeah. And he's going through some like major, major behavioral stuff right now.
Yeah. This is all why I only had one. I couldn't physically handle two.
yeah, I don't even know what I was thinking.
My son has given me 3 beautiful grandkids, but I'm telling you what, I spend 10 days there and I'm ready to come home. I love them to death, but.
It's not easy.
Uh-uh.
Kids are just different now than like when I was a kid.
Yeah. There's so much. That's not fair. They get this, they get that, you know. When we were told to be quiet and to listen, we were quiet and we listened. Now my granddaughter's like flips off and.
Yeah.
I'm like.
I'm done with my letters.
Okay. So what?
Fail.
What we can do is just go back to the first one and do another coat, and you'll see how much brighter it gets. See how much brighter they get as you do a second coat. But go back to the first letter you did, because these are the ones you just finished with are still wet, so they won't stick the same. But see how much brighter they get when we do a second coat. Because we want them to be bright to show up on the board. Yeah, I go to see my grandkids like every 3 months. I was just there not too long ago.
Where do they live?
They live in Oklahoma.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. stinks, but my son has a really good job there, and he was only supposed to live there for 2 years. Ended up, now it's, the oldest is 11, so it's a lot longer than 2 years.
Yeah.
Someday I hope they'll move here. A lot of their family's here. They have a big support system here, but I don't know. There's not, he couldn't make the same money here that he makes there.
Yeah. That's a big deal.
Yeah. Well, especially when she doesn't work, because it would be too much to put three kids in daycare, you know?
Right.
And, you know, it's just easier for them if she's not working, because she can take care of baseball and all the other stuff, you know? Mm-hmm. And the youngest plays baseball, the middle one cheers, and the oldest one hasn't decided what she wants to do this year yet. But they're not in the lockdown like we are. They're going to school, but only going to school 3 days a week.
Well, like, what is that, right? Like, if you're going to go to school, I don't know.
They're going to school 3 days and virtual learning 2 days.
Hmm.
And they're flipping the kids. So, you know, if you're in group A, you go to school Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, then you virtual learn Thursday, Friday, then the following week you do the opposite or something like that. Or you do it for X, Y, Z weeks, and then you do this X, Y, Z. And it's just for now. They're hoping to be back to regular school by December. But their case count is so low compared to ours.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because the population there is a lot less, for one. And for two, they didn't get hit with a lot of international travel.
Right.
You know, we got hit with all these people coming from New York when they weren't supposed to. You know, and all the international travel, we're a big hub for it. Oklahoma is not a big hub for international travel.
Right.
So it all depends on, you know, like what has come in and out of your state and your governor. It also depends on your governor and what they want to do.
Right.
So. And their governor doesn't believe in vaccinations are mandatory, so.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I don't agree with that part, but I guess he doesn't vaccinate his kids.
I didn't realize there were any states like that left.
Well, we're talking about Oklahoma. I guess it just, he doesn't make it mandatory, but he also doesn't discourage it. You know what I mean? Like, he says it's your own choice and it's up to you. Oklahoma has a lot of military towns too in there.
Really?
Mm-hmm. There's a lot of bases in Oklahoma. There's two within 10 minutes of where my kids live. Tinker Air Force Base and another one. Tinker is just the one I see all the time, so I remember that one. And that's where my husband went to train for his work, was Oklahoma. It was like 20 years ago, but he went to training there for like a month. So they do a lot of that kind of stuff.
I've never been there.
I would have never been there if it wasn't for my grandkids, my son and my daughter-in-law. Honestly, it was never on my even radar to go there.
Right.
It's not a bad state. It's just not, it's not Colorado. It's not Las Vegas. You know, it's nothing. There's nothing really there to bring you there unless you're military or work or. It's actually corporate headquarters for a lot of places like Love's Auto Group, you know, like Love's truck stops and gas stations and stuff. It's their corporate headquarters is there. It's an inexpensive place to live and an inexpensive place to have corporate headquarters. So there's a lot of corporate headquarters there.
Interesting.
Yeah, I didn't know all that until I read it. Wouldn't have known it, you know. I lived half of my life in New Hampshire and half of my life here, so I don't really know too much about other places other than those two places, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I know a lot about Boston, Massachusetts, you know, New England, Vermont, Connecticut, just because I lived up there.
Right.
And it only takes you 2 hours to get from one place to the other. Most of the place, most of them, except for New Hampshire, it's long, like Florida. But I lived in the south of New Hampshire, so I lived on the, I lived an hour from Boston, an hour from Vermont, you know.
Mm-hmm.
That's cool. 30, an hour from Maine, so I got to see a lot of different states for that, but. Oh, I hear baby. But I was born here. I'm a Floridian by birth.
And then you grew up in New Hampshire?
I grew up here. No, I grew up here, and then I moved to New Hampshire when I was 18. Senior year of high school, my dad moved us there.
I've never been there either.
It's pretty. It's really nice. And a lot of people that live here are from the north, like the New England area, New Hampshire, you know, New Jersey, Boston, New York, that area. So it's really nice. And a lot of the people that live here are from up there. I've run into more people from the north than I do from people from Florida in Florida.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. The new owners of Kokomo's are from New York. The people that used to own Castaways were from New Jersey. The lady that owns Oak Bistro, she's from not Michigan, but Philadelphia area, I think. I'm not sure. But she's not from here. She's lived here a while, but she's not from here.
I wonder how they find.
I don't know, something about Florida. The people that used to own Wellington Trace were from Russia.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's now an Indian restaurant. I don't even know if it's still open. It's changed so much.
Which one is that?
It was called the White Elephant, and then it was Wellington Trace. It used to be some sort of steakhouse back in the day. It's in the old Wellington Mall.
Oh, I don't go that way very often.
Yeah. It was the only reason I knew about it is because I used to teach class there. I don't anymore. They're not even, I don't foresee a paint class in an Indian restaurant. And the brewery, the people that own the Royal Palm Beach Brewery, they're not from Florida either, I don't think.
I still haven't been there.
That's a cute place. I really like them. And the owners are really, really nice.
Yeah, I need to, now that I'm not pregnant, I need to go there.
I'm hoping to be back there to teach a class, maybe at the end of the year, if we can get out of this phase one and into phase two and three. So once you get your second coat on your letters, we'll just let me know, and then we'll move on to our orange and our purple.
Yep, I'm on to my orange board.
Oh, you are doing a second coat? Okay.
Yeah, I need to.
Yeah, really, mine's showing through too.
It kind of looks cool though, it looks rustic.
Yeah. And plus the girls are going to be floating on top of it, so it doesn't have to be. We're going to have to do a layer of purple on them, like the plain purple. Yeah, I like New Hampshire. I like New England, and I like going up there to visit, but I don't want to live up there in the winter.
No way.
My husband and I have been talking about maybe getting like a little camper and pulling it up there for like a month at a time or something, but right. Not until he retires, so. It won't be right away. It'll be like a couple years down the road.
Yeah, go there for when it's nice.
Yeah, for like the summer, the June and July, it's really nice up there. And then also October. Beautiful in October.
When everything's changing colors.
Yeah.
Cool.
October's my favorite month up there. And really only the first 2 weeks of October.
Yeah, because then it starts getting cold, right?
Yeah, then I'm ready to go. Yeah. And June and July is good because everybody's up on the lake and it's really nice. And I don't go to the beach there, though. I mean, I do to walk on the beach, but I don't go swimming in the beach. The beach is always cold there.
I would imagine, right?
Ugh. Yeah, I have never, my entire 27 years living there, I can honestly tell you I've probably been in the ocean twice and only to my knees. Because it was just so dang cold. Now, the good thing about up there is that they have a lot of rocks on the beach, like big boulder rocks. And what happens is it creates tide pools. And some of the tide pools can be like 2 feet deep. So you can sit in the tide pools and the tide pools get up to like, you know, 80, 85 degrees. So if you're laying out in the sun and you need to cool off, you can go splash in the tide pool.
That's
and
cool.
A tide pool you can see the bottom of. I'm not a big fan of not being able to see the bottom of anything.
Oh, I'm right there with
you. I can't do it.
No. I don't want something to like touch my feet.
Yeah. So the whole thing with the lakes is if I go in a lake, I got to see the bottom of wherever I'm going to be, you know?
Right.
So if I don't see the bottom, I don't go in it. And God forbid seaweed touches me. I'll freak out. Not seaweed, but lake weed or whatever they want to call it. The lake stuff.
Ew. I don't know. I don't think I've ever been to a lake.
It's but I know pretty. About weed. Yeah.
I'm not a fan of when I can't see at the beach.
Yeah. If I can't see the bottom of it, I don't go in it. And I don't know why I'm like that now, because when I was growing up as a kid, I was fine. I could go in the ocean and surf and play with the manatees and stuff like that. But now that I'm an adult, I'm afraid of everything.
Me too.
And I grew up here. So when you get done with your orange and you want to go back with your plain purple like this, and you want to go over your girls and see how it makes them darker.
Is this the straight purple?
Yeah, just straight purple. It'll make them darker. So the purple underneath kind of gives it a primer, and then we'll just go over it with the straight purple. Yeah, we went to the Keys, and we went snorkeling on Alligator Reef, and we were at Hens and Chickens. I don't remember which one we were at, but whichever one we were at, the current was really strong. And you could see the current moving, like you could see the stuff, the coral reef underneath, like swishing back and forth. And my sister jumps in, my brother-in-law jumps in, my niece jumps in, her boyfriend jumps in, my husband jumps in, and here I am sitting on the boat going, I'm not jumping in. I get my noodle, and then I grab the rope that's tied to the boat, and then I jump in. Because the current's always stronger than me. I'm not a strong swimmer, and I'm afraid I'm going to get caught up in the current. And my husband knows it. So when I go snorkeling with them and I'm in the water, he says he's constantly, like, he looks down, looks up to make sure I'm still there.
He needs to, like, tie a rope to you.
Oh, I do. I hold on to the rope. I hold on to the rope that's tied to the boat.
Oh, that's, yeah.
I'm afraid I'm going to wash away. That's the only way I go in, is if I can hold on to the rope. On my personal Facebook page, I posted a picture of me me with the fish, because my sister has a GoPro, and she holds on to a handful of food and then lets it go right in front of you and then takes the picture. So she gets a really good picture with the fish. Mm-hmm. And you, with my pink noodle, holding on to the white rope. And I'm like, I don't care. So I wrote, the current was stronger than me, and I'm looking at the fishies.
That's awesome.
And I don't care. I'm not dead. Or shark somewhere. Then I have these friends that go lobster mini diving, free diving, and gets all kinds of lobsters. And I have one friend who's a very good artist, and she goes shark diving. And I'm like, you're nuts.
Part of me wants to do that, and then the other was like, I don't know.
I would do shark diving in a cage. I would go down in a cage if I didn't go more than 10 feet and I was in a cage. I would not do it without the cage, though.
The cage freaks me out, too, because then I think about, like, what if I get stuck in the cage and I can't get out of the water?
Oh, no, I'm not worried about that because they have it attached to a lift and I've seen them do it, so I'm not worried about that part. I just wouldn't be able to swim away from a shark again. Not a strong swimmer.
Yeah. And,
you know, sharks are unpredictable, just like alligators. So right. You never know when they think you're going to look good enough to eat. So they say they're not attracted to us, but I don't know. I don't believe them.
I don't want to chance it.
Exactly. I don't want to lose a limb to a shark. Thank you very much. I like this look. Like, see how it, with the spongy thing, it looks very mystical.
Yeah, mine's like, you can see it, like, through there.
Yeah, but we can put another coat on.
Thin layers, because it's, like, streaky. I think I'm light-handed.
You like it like that?
Well, I'm saying I think I'm, like, light-handed because I have really, like, big streaks.
No, you can see mine. Look at mine on the camera.
It's hard to tell.
Here, I'll hold it up.
Okay.
Yeah. I think it's just because we only did one coat, and the purple is so opaque. That's just what happens. We could have mixed a little black in there, I guess, but I don't know. I think that would have made it too dark.
Probably.
We can do another coat of this after if you want. But I like the streaky thing. I think it looks good. Did I give you glitter?
I think so.
We can always put glitter on this.
You put like a layer over it?
Is mm-hmm. it glitter? We can always put a layer of glitter over it.
That would be fun.
Then it'll take away some of the streaks. Oops, I just dropped popcorn.
It'd be completely dry though, right?
Uh-huh. But we can set it aside and do our polka dots on our board. I gave you some of these dauber things, right?
Yes.
So I don't know if you think your letters need another coat or not.
They look good.
Okay. On mine, I can still see the wood through, but that's okay. I don't mind that. Some of mine are still a little wet in spots. Moving inside. I need to clean up, so I have a big table or bigger table space. My helper's coming tomorrow to help me do some cleaning. One of my helpers.
Okay.
Yeah, I haven't been using them that much because I haven't needed them, but I want to have that sale next Saturday, so I kind of need two people to help me get it all straightened out and organized. Just goes faster.
Yeah, are you going to put it on, like, an event on Facebook?
Yeah, I'm going to make an event. I'm actually going to make a flyer type thing for it tonight and try to show, like, the different things I'll have. Mm-hmm. I've just been busy all day, so. And make an event. It's on my calendar, so a few people have reached out and asked me what it's all about, but I'll probably make an event for it too. And then I'll probably run an ad on it.
All right.
So, if you want to take your orange piece and lay it on your board so you don't put extra dots on, you can. Your orange piece is cut to shape your board a little bit on one side. I think it goes this way where goes to the bend, you know, it should line up with your board. So where it falls, it should be even, you know what I mean?
Right.
So the circle should kind of line up. So if you want to just lay it there for a minute, with the purple, I don't know if you want to take some of the lighter purple and mix it with the darker purple just to make it a little bit lighter, but not too much lighter. So this is my dark purple and my light purple mixed together. And I'm going to use that for some of my dots. So I'm just going to put this spongy thing in there, twirl it around.
Are you doing the middle size one?
I have two different sizes here. They're all used, so I'm just grabbing whichever. It's like the middle. Yeah, not the smallest, but not the biggest. Okay. And just kind of randomly put your, do a few purple ones. I'm probably going to need more paint. This is not enough. These sponges soak it up. You probably don't want it as light as the one that we used the first time, but kind of half of the other color and half of that. The white will help it show up on the black, though.
Okay.
And the sponges, the round daubers, just spin them. Just spin them on your board, and they leave a little texture, but they give you a better dot if you spin it. They take forever to dry. And then you can do the same thing with the yellow. I think I'm just going to use the yellow that we used on the letters without mixing any darker yellow into it.
Yeah. Just
a little brighter on the black. Yeah, I like the brighter. See how bright it is?
Oh, it's super bright. I have to go wash mine out.
Oh, you don't have, I only gave you one set? I'm sorry.
It's okay.
And you could do like a half a dot too.
I could probably use those different sizes. That would be cute too.
Yeah, that would be cute. Yeah, these circle daubers last a long time. Some of these that I have over here, I've had for like a year. As long as you clean them up, they last a while. They're better quality than these black sponge brushes.
Right.
They should be. They cost more.
Yeah, I have some sponge brushes that I've had for like years.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do too. My personal stash.
Right.
Painting was not my first art love. I have my degree in art, but my major was photography.
Really?
Mm-hmm. That's why when people say to me, how did you get involved in painting? I'm like, well, it wasn't my first choice. It's actually just been in the past 6 years that I've been doing the painting as a career. I used to own a bar in New Hampshire, and where I own the bar, we used to have somebody come in like me and do paint night, but just with canvases. They didn't really do anything else. And no, I take that back. We did glassware and mirrors, but that's how I really got started with it and fell in love with it, was from doing that. So the lady that used to do ours at my bar up north, she was coming to Fort Lauderdale and Miami. First, she was going on a vacation with her family. And then a couple of other paint and sip studio owners were coming here to kind of like do a mini convention.
Mm-hmm.
Invited me down to Fort Lauderdale to meet with them. And I was saying, oh, I'd love to do this like for my second job instead of getting a waitressing or bartending job. And she's like, you should. And she really is the one that encouraged me to do it as a part-time job. So I started out doing it part-time. And then I was working a 9-to-5 job, and then I finally quit my 9-to-5 job and did it full time.
Awesome.
I know. bus. And now with the coronavirus, I'm questioning that, you know, because.
Right.
But my husband doesn't want me to work full time. He doesn't want me to work a different job. He wants me to just hang in there because I don't have an overhead.
Right.
I don't have to worry. And he makes enough money to support us. So not like my job was really buying a lot of extra stuff anyways. I mean, it pays for like me to go see my grandkids and stuff like that, but we don't rely on my income because when you do something like this, it's so sporadic. You can't rely on it. So
right. It's too bad that people don't realize that the virtual is a great option.
I know. And it's partly my fault. I don't promote it enough, but I think people just don't get it. I think they're getting it more now with virtual school and everything. Right. But I'm not one of those people that hammer something down somebody's throat either. So I'm very chill.
It would be good for like moms that can't get a babysitter, you know?
Exactly. Yeah. And I even offered to start class a little later, you know, like 8 o'clock and where the kids go to bed too.
Right.
So this, when you lift this up, this orange thing isn't glued down yet. So just be careful. Okay. I've done that. That's why I say this.
I probably would do that too.
It's funny because some of my helpers are like, you say some of the funniest things, and I'm like, that's because I've done them. Trust me, I've learned. I've fallen. Like when I say be careful of that, blah, blah, blah. And I say that because I'm the one that has fallen backwards with all that stuff in my hands or whatever. Oh, and they laugh at me. I'm like, I'm not joking. Looking kind of cute. I like the white mixed into it. So when you get done doing your polka dots, they're going to take a minute to dry. So what I would suggest is taking one of your glues and just going around the perimeter of the board. It doesn't have to be super thick or anything. Just get like a good bead on there. And it doesn't have to be continuous. Like you can pick it up and go. And you don't really need to go in the middle because it doesn't matter. It's not like it's furniture. Oops, I had a little bit of yellow on my finger. Look at that. And the E6000 is good because you can move it to where you need it to be. So if you put it a little too high, you can slide it down. Then I just press it down. And I got a little bit of yellow on mine, but I think the girl's broom is going to cover it. But I'm going to... Oh, it's coming right off. It's just some paint stuck to my finger. And then you can set this aside and we can see if our girls are dry and put some glitter on them if you want.
Okay.
I keep saying set it aside, like I think you have 100 places to put things.
I actually put the leaf on my table.
Oh, you did? You're like, yeah. I'm crafting tonight. I'm putting this in here.
Yeah.
So if you want, we could try a second coat on this, or you can see what mine looks like with the glitter on it and see if you want to do the glitter. You want me to try it and you can see it?
I just put the glitter on it. It looks awesome.
Oh, it does. Okay, good.
Yes.
Oh, Mike, this is black glitter. I wonder how this is going to look.
Ooh, purple and black look really good together.
Yeah, see, this is black craft twinkles, just like the clear one. I grabbed the wrong one, but I'm going to try it and see. Oh, yeah, this looks good.
I'm just going to make it look purple.
Yeah, it's going to look spookier. I'll show you. You see it?
Yeah, that's cool. I like that.
Yeah. Give it a try, see what it looks like. I like glitter.
Me too. It's not bad.
I think glitter makes everything better. Jen likes glitter too. The one that's missing the call. Nancy does too. Nancy's another one that's coming, gonna watch the rewind. Jen's was one of my very first customers back when I started, and she used to come to Castaways a lot.
That's cool.
Yeah, she used to have.
Castaways, that was at Ibis, right?
Yeah, that was at the Ibis Shopping Center.
Yeah, I forgot about that.
Yeah, that was one of my first restaurants. That was actually my first restaurant that I did classes in.
That's cool.
I did private classes, but that was my very first real restaurant that I did class. I used to be there every Wednesday night.
That's awesome.
Yeah, they were really good to me, and they used to have all my stuff hanging up in the restaurant. I was sad when they left.
That was all the way to the east, right?
Yes. That was the one on the end all the way to the east. I guess it was a taco place before it was Castaways. Yeah, but I didn't know it as that. Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's gone through a lot.
Yeah, that's what the people that used to work there would say. Because a lot of them would go from the old place to the new place, you know, just so they could have a job. And then some of the people that used to work there now work at Kokomo's.
I wonder why they can't stay in business.
I know. Well, I think when the extension road opens up, somebody's going to snag it up.
Yeah.
When they finally get that extension road pushed through there, when and if it ever happens.
I think it would help a lot.
It'll help them a lot, yeah. Ibis people won't be happy, but it'll help the plaza a lot. I don't know why Avanti doesn't move down there. They do really well.
Yes, they do. We love them.
Yeah, we do too. They have good food. Doesn't make you sick.
Right. Jabrewski's and Avanti. Huh? We get J-Brew all the time too.
Oh yeah, we love J-Brew too. We just had them last night. Yeah, last night. And they had their Tuesday's $10 pizza special.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Yeah, we didn't know about it till we called. They're like, oh, we have a special tonight, $10 for a large pizza, because we were getting a medium. We're like, okay, we'll take it. Yeah. We like them a lot, because there's some places when you eat them, you don't feel good afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
And those two we have really good luck with. And there's another one over, it's quite a far ways away, but they're really good food, is Two Twisted Italians.
Oh, I've heard about that, but I haven't been there yet.
Yeah, they're really good. So if you're over in the area, you can always get it to go. The owner's name is Tommy, and his food is amazing.
Yeah, I've heard that.
Yeah. And he's a really nice guy. Really, really good food. I love the glitter. I love the black glitter. I'm going to show you close-up. Sure.
Yeah, that's really cute.
That's going to take a few minutes to dry, but we can glue this down and it can still dry because it doesn't touch anything.
Let me see if I can turn my camera on and show you mine. I don't know how to do that. Is there a way you can turn it? Oh, yeah.
I think I can ask you to join. Oh, you got it.
Hold on. I have to go over it.
Oh yeah, I like it.
Glittery.
Yeah, I can see it twinkling.
Yes, that's awesome.
So, I don't know if you have a blow dryer or if that's going to be a good thing to do with the baby to get the dots to dry so we can put the letters on, or you can just let it sit and glue the letters on after and send me a picture, whatever's easier.
Yeah, I'll probably have to do that.
Yeah, because I know you
already up again.
Oh no, again?
Yes. He's rough at night. It's really.
Oh no, he's a day sleeper, huh?
Which, well, I don't know. He keeps going back and forth. He just at night he's just restless. Like he has really bad gas.
Oh yeah.
And at night it's just like worse for him.
Oh.
So I'll probably have to glue it on after.
That's fine. At least you'll have time to let it dry.
Yes.
So I'm just gonna take my girls and put them in the middle here because we already did our orange stripe. Well, I did mine. And if you plop it down and then just kind of center it up, and then you just have to let this dry. So I'm just going to push it down and hope I don't. There you go. So it'll take a few minutes to stick because the E6000 takes a few minutes to set up, but I'm going to wait for the rest to dry too to do
my work. The E6000 on the girls?
I did E6000 on the orange, and I did E6000 on the purple, but, you know, the orange thing, you might want to put something heavy on it just to kind of hold it down because mine's not really staying down. I think it's my table, too. It's got, like, a little bow in it. There we go.
Yeah, mine's good. It's not moving.
Okay. Yeah, mine wasn't just really – it was kind of bowing up because my table kind of bows in the middle, so I'm just – putting my 2 heavy gallon paints on there to hold it down for a minute till it sets up. But the E6000 takes a few minutes to set up. And then once it's set, it doesn't move. But, and then I'll put the letters on. So if you look at your letters, your Hocus Pocus, this part of the H goes on the bottom. You have the picture, right?
Yes.
Okay. So just look at your picture. And there is 2 size letters. So when you line them up, just make sure you got all the right, because this U and this U, there is a size difference, like you said, see?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so just make sure you grab the right one before you stick it on. And then size different on the S's, too.
Just by looking at it, I didn't even realize it.
Yeah, you don't until you lay them side by side. Yeah, the C is smaller. Yeah, the S's are definitely different sizes, see?
This makes me want to watch it.
Go watch it?
Mm-hmm.
You can watch it while you're feeding the baby, right?
Yeah.
Baby wakes up tonight. It'll probably be on Netflix and stuff pretty soon.
Yeah, I would think so.
I think my daughter-in-law owns it on a DVD.
I might have it on my Amazon from last year.
I never even saw it until last year.
What?
I know. Well, I'm older than you, so it wasn't my generation. It was my sister's generation, and
right.
It was younger than me. Yeah, no, I'm 52.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I did not know that.
Yeah, so I'm older, so it wasn't really a thing when I was a kid, you know?
Right.
It came out later, and by the time it came out, I was working 2 jobs, so I didn't really watch TV for the longest time.
Have you seen Halloween Town?
Yes. I actually watched that with my grandkids like 3 years ago.
Yeah, that's another classic from my time.
Mm-hmm.
The Hocus is my favorite.
Yeah, I actually watched it last year. I think I watched it with my grandkids because I hadn't seen it and everybody was giving me crap about it. And then it was on TV like 3 times in a row and everybody kept tagging me because every time I went to a class and I did another Hocus Pocus thing, I would always say, I hadn't seen it yet. And they're like, how could you not see it? And I'm like, dude, I think it was January, I didn't watch TV at all. And if I did, it was just in the background, and my husband had put a TV out in my shop for me, thank God, because now that I'm out here all the time, you know, but I, you know, when I was working, I was doing classes out of the house almost every night of the week. It wasn't until the Castaways closed down that I started doing them here on Wednesday nights.
That's awesome. I think the first time I've done a class with you was the Friends. No, I had to have done another one, I think.
Didn't you do one at Kokomo's or no?
I did the Friends door hanger.
The friend's door hanger, yeah. So you did that one at Kokomo's, right?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I wanted that tiered tray so bad.
I got one as a sample. I was going to paint up.
Oh my gosh. Next week. But I'm like, I don't have like ever to decorate for that, you know?
Yeah.
So
that's
like,
something you don't really decorate for unless you're a huge Friends fanatic.
Right.
But I fall asleep watching Friends almost every night.
I love it. It's such a feel-good show. I just finished it like last year. It was like I started it and I totally binge-watched it because I had never seen it. And my really good friend is like, what? So every time I go to her house, we like just turn it on and watch it. And I'd sit there for hours and I binge-watched it pretty quickly. Mm-hmm.
I used to rush home to watch it.
Like every week. Turn off Netflix.
I know, but it's on Hulu.
Yes, and I just got Hulu just so we could too. Watch basketball. Oh, yeah. Speaking of losing basketball,
I just got Hulu because when I was in Oklahoma, I watched The Masked Singer with my grandkids, and I had to see how it ended. So
oh
now I'm watching. Yeah, now I'm watching a different series on there, and I'm watching Karate Kai, The Karate Kid, Cobra Kai.
Oh yes, I saw that the other day. Like a little, it popped up like, "Do you want to watch?" type thing.
Yeah. If you saw Karate Kid 1 and 2, you would definitely get the whole thing. If you haven't seen Karate Kid, you probably want to go back and watch Karate Kid first and then watch this. Yeah. Because it's definitely a true spinoff of Karate Kid. Like with Johnny and Ralph Macchio's character. I forget his name now. Gosh.
I haven't seen it. I don't know.
Lorenzo is his last name. Lorenzo's Auto Group. It's good. It's really good. And I saw a few people on Facebook comment about it. And I was like, oh, I didn't know this was on. And then I turned it on and I was like, now I'm addicted to it. Definitely is a good show. I've been binge watching a lot of stuff. And I never watch TV. It's just funny because I'm so addicted to TV now.
Right. I did when I first had the baby, the first 3 weeks, I like didn't leave my bedroom with him. And so I just like started watching all the shows like that I wanted. I binge watched. So I watched so much TV. It was crazy.
It gets addicting. I'll be out here till 2 a.m. sometimes.
Oh my gosh. That must be so nice.
My neighbor across the street, she's also one of my customers. She's like, when I take the dog out for a walk, I always look over to see if your shop light's on. She goes, then I know I can text you if I want something. She's a night owl too.
Class.
So when she walks the dog, she like checks to see if my shop light's on.
That's funny.
Yeah, she's funny. She's super nice. Her whole family's nice. So when you get done, just send me a picture. You know how to tie the rope on?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, and I just put the bow in the hole of one of the holes for the rope. So you could tie it in there, or you could tie it on the string, whatever's easier for you.
Okay.
And then I know you probably got to – the dots won't be dry for a few minutes, and you don't want to smear them. So you can
– like, okay. Because it is really light, my orange one.
Your orange one? So you can do it again?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah. So if you let them dry for a few minutes and do them again, they should come out pretty good. You can also blow dry it too if you want. It's up to you. I don't know. Some people, one lady goes, I don't own a blow dryer.
Oh my God. Don't. How do you say that?
What's that?
Wait, because I didn't know how to use it. I can't blow dry my own hair. So my girlfriend, I was like, this is a really, really good blow dryer. Do you want it? And now that I gave it to her, I need it all the time.
Yeah. I'm like, I know. Some people, I bought a couple at Goodwill. Like I found one at a yard sale for $3 and I got one at Goodwill. And they're just, you know, Conair ones, but they work fine.
Right.
I have one that I left at the brewery. in case I forgot one, because I always forgot stuff when I went to a class there. And I have one at the senior center, because I was doing classes at the senior center on Fridays from 10 to 12. Mm-hmm. And I have one that's still there in the classroom that I use.
Yeah, see, you don't have to bring it, like, remember to bring it with you.
No, but I can't get back in the senior center right now, so.
Oh, I'm sure they're going to be shut down for a long time.
I don't think they'll be back up until next year.
Yeah.
Because they're also Palm Beach County Senior Center. They're owned by the town of Palm Beach. The city, you know, the city organizes and runs them. So yeah, I don't think they'll be back in until after schools are.
Right.
But that's why I do virtual classes on Friday mornings now for all those guys. Because they've all figured it out now. Most of them have figured out the Zoom calls, so.
And, you know, they're probably, like, looking forward to that, you know, and then
that's
their time of getting away.
Some of those people that come to my Friday morning classes have been coming to my Friday, well, to my classes since I've been full-time, and I'll be full-time, I think it's in May of this year coming up, for 4 years. So
Wow. They've
been coming to me for 4 years and or have done my classes in some capacity. Some of them have been with me the whole 6 years. So it's really awesome. Nice. Well, thank you very much for getting on. Are you doing tomorrow's class?
I am, yes.
Okay.
My sister-in-law is going to do it with me.
Awesome. You'll love it. It's awesome.
So I'm just bringing the brushes for that class.
Yeah, you don't need all the sponges and stuff. Did I give you a popsicle stick?
No.
Do you have a popsicle stick?
Maybe.
Well, if you don't, you can just use like the, if one of these foam brushes is dead, you can just pull the foam piece off and throw it away and you can use the wood part of that. You just need something like, I don't know if you have a palette knife hanging around. One of those cheap plastic ones, but we're going to use a popsicle stick instead of a palette knife to brush on that gold, like in the picture. I don't know if you see the gold in there, but no, it's kind of textured in the background. That I just use a palette knife for, or a popsicle stick.
Okay. I can have like a Play-Doh knife. I can use that.
Oh yeah, that'll work. Or even like a plastic butter knife would work.
Okay.
If you have one of those. I know I always have more knives left over than anything else in my plasticware.
Oh, yeah. I think I have a bunch. And if not, I use a handle of a plastic fork, too.
Yeah, anything like that. That'll work. Because that, you know, I didn't go out and buy a whole bunch of palette knives for one painting.
Right.
I used the popsicle stick for mine, and it worked just fine. So we'll use that. But, yeah, that'll be a fun painting. It's a little detailed, but it's fun. And I'll do that one on the easel, so it'll be a different view. You won't see my floor or my lap, but you'll just see the picture on the easel.
Okay.
But it'll be cool.
All right, awesome. All right.
Sounds good. Thank you so much.
All right, have a good night.
You too.
Bye.
Bye-bye.